So the title is Casuistic Cost Automata, a new variant of weakness. This is a joint work with Michael Vandenboom. So the aim of this work is to study the theory of regular cost functions, which is a quoting extension of the notion of languages. This comes from the fact that we already solve a bunch of problems related to languages by considering this kind of cost functions. And to define such functions, we can use, so we can define them on words or trees, which can be finite or infinite. And to define this function, we can use various things as automata, logics, or algebraic structures. So how can we use an automaton to define such a function? We start from a non-deterministic automaton A, as usual, but we add some counters which start at the value zero. And on each transition, we can do some operations on the counter. So there is an increment. We add one to the value of the counter. Reset, we set the value back to zero. So check, basically, we look at the value and we put it in a bag for later use. Or we are also allowed to do nothing on the counter. And we will use this automaton to define a function from words here to n with infinity value. So how does it work? There is a semantic called the B semantic. So when we look at a run of such an automaton, we can look at all the checked values along the run, and we just remember the maximum one to give a value to the run. And the semantic of the automaton on word u will be the infimum of all the run values on this word. For instance, here, we want to compute the minimal length of a block of A's surrounded by B's. So here, this is a non-deterministic automaton, and each run computes the value of one block of A. So the infimum of all runs will be the minimum length of a block of A's. There is a dual semantic called the S semantic, where so all is reversed. The value of one run is the minimal check value, and the value among all runs is the value of the maximal run. So here, if we want to do the same thing, we can do it with a deterministic automaton, which just count each block. So there is only one run, and we will collect the values of each block, and the value of the run will be the infimum value of all the blocks. So unfortunately, we know that it is undecidable whether two such automata compute the same function. That is why we relax what we want to decide, and now we just want to look at if two functions are bounded on the same set. And this is decidable, so what we will call a cost function will be an equivalence class for this relation. For instance, here, if A is represented by the green curve and B by the blue, A and B do not have the exact same values, but they are equivalent. On the other hand, here, if we take for A this line, the set of red dots will be an example of set where A is not bounded, but B is bounded, which is a witness which proves that A is not equivalent to B. So from now on, all functions will be considered up to this equivalence relation. So this has proven to be useful by the past because we can decide a bunch of properties of regular languages on some structure. So I will pass this. So this is the type of automata we need to decide this. Now we will be interested as input structure by sigma-labeled infinite trees, so which is a particular case of cost function. So as before, we can define the dual B and S semantics, but now they define cost function from trees to N union infinity. We can put any acceptance conditions that we want on infinite trees, so it could be Bushi, Kobushi, or anything that works on infinite words. Now the problem is that we do not know if this is decidable for such cost functions, so we have to look at subsets, subclasses. So a first remark is that if we take an automaton A, which does not have any counter, and we want to consider it as a B or S automaton, then it will define the characteristic function of L as a B automaton and the characteristic function of the complement of L as a S automaton where the characteristic function is defined like this. So that is why we can consider that switching between B and S is like a complementation of cost functions. And moreover, we can remark that the equivalence between characteristic function of languages is the same as equality of language. So by considering language as cost function, we strictly extend the language theory. So now that we saw that any language can be considered as a cost function, we can ask, does the theorem on language still hold for all cost functions, and how can we extend them? So this is a theorem we were interested in extended. So that is a theorem from Rabin, Kupferman, and Vardy, which says that it is equivalent for a language to be both Bushi definable and that the complement is Bushi definable, and to be definable by a weak alternating automata, or equivalently by the weak monadic second order logic. So I will define what is a weak alternating automata here. It's an automaton which is defined via a game. So it has priorities 1 and 2. And there we forbid any cycle in the transition function with both priorities. So it means that there is a bound of the number of times we can switch between 1 and 2 in a play of the automaton. And so a tree is accepted if the if player, the existential player, has a winning strategy for this tree. So now, since we want to extend Rabin's theorem, we need to define what is the analog of this for a cost function. So the simple idea is to just add some counters. So we take a weak automaton and we add a set of counters. Now Eve is trying to minimize the value of the play, and Adam is trying to maximize, and the value of a tree will be the optimal strategy for Eve. So this is called a weak B automata, and this has been introduced in the previous paper by Van den Boom. So in the same paper, it's kind of dark. so there was a translation from weak automata to Bibushi, to both Bibushi and S-Bushi. So this shows that the class of weak definable cost functions is included in the intersection of these classes. Moreover, the class have a number of good properties, such as closure by a number of operators and equivalence with an analog of weak MSO that we call weak cost MSO. So now the question is, can we extend Rabin's theorem on cost functions? So is the red class all the intersection, or is it a strict inclusion? So for a long time, we tried to prove this conjecture that a cost function is definable by a weak B automaton if and only if it is Bibushi and S-Bushi. But it turns out that it's not exactly it. Instead, we had to consider the quasi-weak B automata, and that is the class that admits a Rabin-style characterization. So what are quasi-weak B automata? So I remember that weak are alternating automata with a bound of the number of alternation between priorities, and this is equivalent to the fact that there is no cycle with both 1 and 2 in the transition function. So here we are still alternating Bibushi, and we still want to bound the number of alternation, but now we are allowed to make this bound depend of the value of the function. So it means that if the cost function gets bigger, the bound is also allowed to get bigger. So, and it is equivalent to such a structural condition, that is, now we can have a cycle with both priorities 1 and 2, but if we do, we must increase the value of the function, so we must have an increment on the cycle and not a reset. And moreover, this class is a strict extension of the weak class. So we got this separation result. So to conclude, so we showed that it is a quasi-weak B automata and not the weak B automata that have a Rabin-style characterization. If A and B are, so and all the procedures are effective, it means that if we have a quasi-weak B automata, we can get Bibushi and S-Bushi, and if we have a Bibushi and S-Bushi, we can get a quasi-weak B automaton. And moreover, we can decide if A and B are two quasi-weak B automata, we can decide the equivalence. So yes, so the class is strictly more expressive. So this is a new class which is a kind of symmetric because it is the intersection of Bibushi and S-Bushi, for which we can decide equivalence of cost function. As a corollary, we get that if, so back to classic languages, if we are given a Bushi automaton, non-deterministic, we can now decide if the language it defines is in fact a weak language. And it's reusing reduction by Colcombe and loading. So now the main open question of this this field is, can we decide the equivalence for all cost parity automata? Which seems to be a very difficult question. So, thank you.